Hello, my dear viewers. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are safe in your homes. Today, I have brought a new poem, Koshish Karne Walo Ki Kabhi Haar Nahi Hoti, from class 10th Hindi, which is written by Sohan Lal Trivedi. इस कविता में कवि ने यह संदेश दिया है कि सतत प्रयत्नशील व्यक्ति की निश्चित रूप से जीत होती है। समस्याओं से मुंह न मोड़कर आगे बढ़ना चाहिए, कविता का आशय। इस कविता में कोशिश करने से सफलता प्राप्त करने का संदेश मिलता है। कवि कहते हैं कि जीवन की प्रतियोगिता में असफलता से विमुख न होते हुए अपनी कमियों को खुद पहचान कर स्वप्रयत्न से लगातार आगे बढ़ने से हार कभी नहीं होती है। ओके, सतत प्रयत्नशील व्यक्ति मीन्स अ हार्ड वर्किंग पर्सन। समस्याओं प्रॉब्लम्स, सफलता सक्सेस, देन प्रतियोगिता कॉन्टेस्ट, असफलता फेलियर, विमुख इट इज अ फीलिंग ऑफ डिमोटिवेशन, स्वप्रयत्न मीन्स सेल्फ एफर्ट, सेल्फ इम्प्रूवमेंट। ओके, सो द पोयम कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती means those who try they never give up. Yes, if a person is hard working, he is dedicated towards his work, he has a target and he know that I have to achieve that target at any cost, then he will not quit. No matter what problem comes in his life, he will never quit because he has already fixed a target. He know what he has to achieve, so for that he has to keep continue, he has to continuously keep moving. Yes, we should not turn our face when any problem comes in our life, because problem will definitely come. So this poem is a encouraging poem, it is a motivational poem. The poet gives three examples, he gives three examples so that we can clearly understand what the meaning of hard work is, how those things work so hard. We should learn from them. Now, what are those three things that we will see? But before that, we will see about the poet, Kavi Parichay. Sohan Lal Trivedi, sun 1906 se sun 1988. सोहनलाल त्रिवेदी जी हिंदी के सुप्रसिद्ध कवि हैं। आपका जन्म 23 फरवरी सन 1906 को हुआ। आपने बनारस हिंदू विश्वविद्यालय से एमए एलएलबी की डिग्री ली और आजीविका के लिए जमींदारी तथा बैंकिंग का काम करते रहे। सन 1938 से सन 1942 तक आप राष्ट्रीय पत्र दैनिक अधिकार के संपादक थे। कुछ वर्षों तक आपने अवैतनिक मीन्स बिना वेतन के बाल पत्रिका बाल सखा का संपादन भी किया। आप महात्मा गांधी से अत्यधिक प्रभावित थे। स्वतंत्रता प्राप्ति के लिए देशभक्ति व ऊर्जा से ओतप्रोत आपकी रचनाओं की विशेष सराहना हुई तथा आपको राष्ट्रकवि की उपाधि से अलंकृत किया गया। सन 1988 में राष्ट्रकवि त्रिवेदी जी का देहांत हो गया। आपकी प्रमुख कृतियां है भैरवी, वास्वदत्ता, कुणाल, पूजा गीत, विश्वान, जुगादार और जय गांधी, बांसुरी, झरना, बिगुल, बच्चों के बापू, दूध बताशा, बाल भारती, शिशु भारती, नेहरू चाचा, सुजाता, प्रभाती आदि आपका प्रमुख बाल साहित्य है। ओके, सुप्रसिद्ध मीन वेल नोन, वेल नोन। देन बनारस हिंदू विश्वविद्यालय मीन बनारस हिंदू यूनिवर्सिटी, आजीविका लाइवलीहुड, जमींदारी लैंडलॉर्ड, देन राष्ट्रीय पत्र मीन्स नेशनल पेपर, संपादक एडिटर, अवैतनिक मीन्स विदाउट टेकिंग द वेजेस, वर्किंग बट विदाउट टेकिंग द सैलरी, बाल पत्रिका चिल्ड्रंस मैगजीन, देन अत्यधिक प्रभावित मीन्स स्ट्रांगली इन्फ्लुएंस्ड, देशभक्ति पेट्रियोटिज्म, ऊर्जा एनर्जी, ओतप्रोत फिल्ड विथ, देन सराहना टू अप्रिशिएट, राष्ट्रकवि नेशनल पोएट, उपाधि डिग्री और टाइटल, देहांत डेथ। ओके, वन मोर बाल साहित्य मीन्स चिल्ड्रंस लिटरेचर. सो हियर सोहनलाल त्रिवेदी इज अ वेल नोन पोएट. ओके ही वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 23rd Feb 1906 एंड डाइड इन 1988. ही कंप्लीटेड हिज MA LLB degree from Banaras Hindu University and he continued to work as a landlord and banking for his living. Then from 1938 to 1942, from 1938 to 1942, he worked as an editor of national paper, which was Dainik Adhikar. For some years, he also edited children's magazine Bal Sakha, for which he was not paid. He was strongly influenced by Mahatma Gandhi. His works were filled with patriotism and energy for gaining independence, which was very much appreciated. And he was also given the title of national poet. Some of his famous works were Bhairavi, Vasudatta, etc. And some of his children's literatures were Bansuri, Jharna, Bigul. These all were children's literature. Okay, so this was about the poet. Now the poem. Leharon se dar kar nauka paar nahi hoti, koshish karne walon ki kabhi haar nahi hoti. Leher means waves. Waves in the sea and in the ocean, that waves is known as leher. Dar means afraid. Nauka, boat. Par means across. Okay, so here the poet is giving the example of a boatsman, the one who sails the boat. As I told you earlier that the poet has given three examples. So one example is of this boatsman. Okay, now the boatsman, when he sails his boat in the sea or in the ocean, what difficulties he face? He face the difficulty of waves is the biggest difficulty for him, and it is very risky. If waves comes in the ocean or sea, it is very difficult for a boat to survive. It will definitely sink in the ocean. So it is very risky, but this boatsman, they are not afraid of the waves, they are not afraid of the difficulties, they are very confident. So they take their boat and they just sail in the sea and oceans without thinking that waves will come, because they know how to handle it. They are very confident. So this confidence we have to take from them. The poet wants us to take the confidence, how these people risk their life and they keep on trying. They sail their boats. Unless and until they reach their destination, they don't stop. So this we have to learn from them. Yes. Now the second. Nanhi cheti jab dana lekar chalti hai, chadti deewaron par 100 baar fisalti hai. Man ka vishwas ragon mein saahas bharta hai, chadkar girna girkar chadna na akharta hai. Aakhir uski mehnat bekar nahi hoti, koshish karne walon ki haar nahi hoti. Nanhi cheeti, small ant. We know the size of the ant, how small it is, how small creature it is. Yes. Dana means grain. Deewar, wall. 100 baar, 100 times. Fisalti means slips. Vishwas, confidence. Rago, nerves. Sahas, courage. Then akharta means to feel bad. Then mehnat means hard work. Bekar, waste. Okay, so we have observed the ants. What it does, it carries small grain in its mouth, and it starts climbing the wall. When it climbs the wall 100 times, it falls. Not exactly 100 times. Here 100 times means many times. Okay, so many times it falls, but it never loses the hope. It keeps on trying and keeps on trying. Okay, and finally it reaches its destination. Wherever it wants to go, it reaches it. So here also we have to learn from this ants, how they do their work, how hardworking they are. They don't quit. Yes, they are so small in size, but they have courage in them to reach their destination, to achieve what they want. So we should learn from them. This was the second example of the poet. Now the third example. डुबकिया सिंधु में गोताखोर लगाता है, जा जाकर खाली हाथ लौट कर आता है। मिलते नहीं सहज ही मोती गहरे पानी में, बढ़ता दुगना उत्साह इसी हैरानी में। मुट्ठी उसकी खाली हर बार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की हार नहीं होती। डुबकिया, डुबकिया मीन्स टू डिप, डिप इन द सी और इन द ओशन। सिंधु मीन्स वाटर, एनी टाइप ऑफ वाटर लाइक रिवर और सी और ओशन, दैट इज सिंधु। गोताखोर मीन डाइवर्स। यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर अ मैन, ही इज इन साइड द वॉटर, ही इज द गोताखोर। ओके, देन सहज, सहज मीन्स इजी। मोती, मोती पर्ल। गहरे पानी मीन्स डीप वॉटर। दुगना मीन्स ट्वाइस। उत्साह एक्साइटमेंट, हैरानी शॉक। Okay, so here the third example the poet is giving of divers. We all know what the divers do. They dip in the deep sea. They go in the deep sea, in the deep ocean, in search of precious pearls. Do they find at one attempt? No. Many times they have to get into the sea. They have to go into the ocean many times, and it is not a safe place. You have so many aquatic animals, but they take the courage of going inside. Yes, they risk their life and they go inside the deep water in search of precious pearls. But they don't get everything at one attempt. But they are not demotivated. They don't lose hope because they are because they have positive mindset. If once they fail, if once they don't get for what they have gone, then that is not a failure for them. They get excitement. Their excitement increases that now if I have not got, next time I will definitely get it. They have a positive mindset, and because of that, they keep going on. They keep trying unless and until they get what they want. So this is the third example the poet is giving to learn from them. We have to learn the courage from them. We have to take motivation from them that how hard they try. They risk their life. They go deep inside the ocean. Yes? So we have to learn from them. Now this is the last stanza of the poem, which is very beautiful and meaningful. असफलता एक चुनौती है, इसे स्वीकार करो, क्या कमी रह गई देखो और सुधार करो। जब तक न सफल हो, नींद चैन को त्यागो तुम, संघर्ष का मैदान छोड़कर मत भागो तुम। कुछ किए बिना ही जय जयकार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती। असफलता मीन्स फेलियर, चुनौती चैलेंज, स्वीकार टू एक्सेप्ट, कमी वीकनेस, सुधार टू इम्प्रूव, सफल सक्सेस, नींद स्लीप, चैन पीस, त्याग सैक्रिफाइस, संघर्ष स्ट्रगल, मैदान ग्राउंड, भागना भागो टू रन, जय जयकार नेम एंड फेम। सो हियर ही इज सेइंग दैट द पोएट इज सेइंग दैट इफ इफ यू फेस एनी फेलियर, एनी टाइप ऑफ फेलियर इन योर लाइफ, you have to accept it as a challenge. Yes, whenever we face any failure in our life, we have to take it as a challenge. And after taking it as a challenge, we need to know that how I failed, what was the reason behind that. You should know the reason why you have failed. You should find out your mistake. Your mistake increases your experience. You get to know from your mistake that where you have done wrong, and you get experience. So सो इट इज नॉट अ वेस्टेज, इफ यू फेल इट इज नॉट अ वेस्टेज ऑफ टाइम, नो, यू लर्न फ्रॉम इट, यू 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 गेट टू नो व्हाट वाज द कॉज व्हाई यू गॉट फेल्ड. सो फेलियर शुड बी एक्सेप्टेड एज अ चैलेंज, बट मेनी ऑफ अस व्हाट दे थिंक दैट फेलियर इज अ शेम. सो आउट ऑफ दैट व्हेन दे फेल एट वन अटेम्प्ट दे गेट डिप्रेस्ड एंड दे गो एंड डू सुसाइड. दैट इज नॉट एट ऑल फेयर, वी शुड नॉट डू लाइक दैट. ओके, वी शुड ऑलवेज हैव अ पॉजिटिव माइंड सेट एंड वी शुड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट वॉट वॉज द रीजन फॉर अवर फेलियर एंड वी शुड कीप ऑन प्रैक्टिसिंग इट. वी शुड कीप ऑन इम्प्रूविंग अवर वीकनेस. वी हैव टू कन्वर्ट अवर वीकनेस इन टू अवर स्ट्रेंथ. येस, देन ओनली वी विल अचीव वॉट वी वॉन्ट. एंड अनलेस यू अचीव योर टारगेट, अनलेस यू आर सक्सीडेड, you should not waste your time, you should not sit simply, you should not waste your time, you should keep on working, keep on trying so that you can achieve what you have targeted. See, life is not like a bed of roses. In life, difficulties will come, problems will come, it is bound to come. It will break you, it will shake you, but how strong you stand, that defines you, that will show your true personality. Yes? So if difficulty comes, you should not run from the ground. You should not turn your face and you should not run from your problem. Difficulties do not come to, it do not comes to destroy you, but it comes to make you realize your hidden potential, your talent, what you have in you. Okay, so let the difficulties know that you too are difficult. Don't run from it. Try to solve it. Try to prove it that you are more stronger than the difficulties. Yes. So in this poem, the poet he wants us to understand that we need to work hard in each and every step of our life, because problems are bound to come. It will come, and running from the problem is not the solution. Then what is the solution? To fight with it, to overcome it. How you react, that is the main thing which will show your true personality. So we should know how to deal with it. And without struggle, no one can get name and fame. We have so many great personalities. We write their names in golden letters. Why? Because they have struggled a lot. They have achieved their target. They have achieved their name. And we feel proud to take their name. We have many great personalities like that. So how they have achieved that? Because of their hard work, because of this struggle, they have done lot many sacrifices in their life. So we should also learn from them. And we should also keep on trying unless we reach our target. Okay, so this was about the poem, Koshish Karne Walo Ki Haar Nahi Hoti. I hope this video was useful. If you like it, hit the like button, share and subscribe it.